Since 2015, Creating Healthy Schools and Communities, or CHISC, grantees and their partners have worked to ensure schools and communities throughout New York State have access to healthy foods and opportunities for physical activity. Here's what CHISC-funded organizations have to say about what they've accomplished over the last 5 years in school settings.
My proudest moment was watching students at Lime Kiln Elementary School run the Daily Mile, a program that encourages kids to run every day. Over the last 2 years, hundreds of students have participated regularly. The kids love it, and the teachers appreciate how much more motivated students are when they return.
One of the things that we've been able to do with Syracuse School District and with the CHISC program, the schools program, is create some great environmental changes. And this started through the development, just the idea that the development and the design and actually laying down of a walking trail that started in just one school. And we've actually grown to 17 different school buildings now throughout the district.
Yoga in year 4 was a hit. Many of our students and teachers who had yoga were very, very proud to say that the breathing and mindfulness techniques helped them both in and out of school.
When Rushton Wyra had decided that they wanted to host their first staff wellness day, none of us were really sure how that was going to work out. So we were really thrilled when not only did they enjoy it, but that they decided to do it every single year.
On this particular walking tour, we had principals join us from different buildings throughout the district. They were all so impressed with all of the CHISC initiatives that had been funded. These included several tower gardens that were being used for a healthy cooking club, healthy marketing that was created by the students with bright, colorful posters of fresh fruits and vegetables, a wellness room that both staff and students were using, a smoothie bar with a bike blender, and also flexible seating in several classrooms.
One story that shows how creating healthy schools and communities has positively impacted wellness in the Unitego High School is through funding a healthy vending machine for student athletes. Coaches are happy that their students are getting healthy snacks and beverage choices. The students love it.
One of my proudest moments working on the CHISC initiative was when the students of CMSP 327 visited the BronxNet studio to talk about their counter-marketing project with us. Here they were standing in the BronxNet studio explaining why it was important to eat healthy and how food marketing companies had been manipulating them and kids like them for years.
In these ways, CHISC has meant that a culture of health and wellness is growing, even across seemingly separate and disparate areas. And in an effort to support all students' ability to be healthy and successful in school, now and in the future.
Here's what CHISC-funded organizations have to say about what they've accomplished over the last 5 years in community settings.
To Clinton County and Essex County, CHISC has meant that we've been able to educate 14 of our townships on the importance of complete streets. Of those 14 townships, 13 have passed complete street resolutions. We've been able to provide 8 of our townships with professionally developed concept plans and implement them. Over the past 5 years, we've been able to work with the communities on over 25 complete street projects.
In January 2020, we held a Street Shared by All community event that drew community members with representation from local government, Seneca County, South Seneca School District, and the Amish community. The event resulted in several additional communities in the South Seneca Central School District mobilizing their communities and acting on complete streets.
One of my proudest moments working on creating healthy schools and communities is our support and capacity that we were able to provide to the Village of Waterloo in Seneca County. They quickly embraced Complete Streets concepts. They attended education and learning opportunities that we were able to provide them.
My proudest moment in the city of Yonkers was when we actually passed Complete Streets legislation unanimously by our city council during year 1 of the grant. That was not an easy feat, but we worked together, certainly with our Life Coalition, our community stakeholders, and our elected officials, and we made it happen.
One of the projects that I'm most proud of that I worked on in the past 5 years of creating healthy schools and communities was to help the Village of Potsdam implement its complete streets policy. And now we have a beautiful network of ADA compliant, pedestrian safe curb ramps in the vicinity of this very busy section of the village.
My proudest moment came while we were at the 2019 convening in Yonkers. The town agreed to take ownership of the signs and the county agreed to install them along County Highway 23 while we were at the convening. Not only were the signs installed, but the 30 mile per hour speed zone was extended further out from the center of the community.
I would be remiss if I didn't mention my very most favorite part of of CHISC would be the veggie van. What started as an idea we had right at the end of CHP for people to access food who would live in food deserts, it came to fruition in a way we could never have dreamed and still going strong.
Bronx Health Reach's faith-based outreach initiative partners, which includes many African American churches, participated in the Old Ways, a Taste of African Heritage culinary program through CHISC. The program increased participants' ability to prepare culturally relevant, nutritious recipes and sparked a new appreciation for how to retain cultural heritage while also preparing healthy foods that help to prevent diet-related diseases.
My favorite part of the CHISC grant has been actually in the last few months working with community agencies, especially the Rockland Community Against Hunger and government agencies to come together during the pandemic to bring a food bank here to Rockland County, which we do not have.
But I'd like to share with you the one that's made me most proud. Yonkers being selected to host the 2019 convening. On tour, others had the opportunity to see how our city was transforming on so many levels. From the revitalization of our downtown waterfront business district to the beauty of our green spaces and residential areas.
Right now, my proudest moment in the work that we do with CHISC has not been realized. It will be realized in years to come when students are graduating, when students are healthier, when employees are healthier and carrying on healthy eating and physical activity behaviors, and we see obesity rates.
By leveraging funds and resources across public and private sectors, the committee was able to influence policy and practice in regards to integrating farm to school and community gardening, healthy food standards, breakfast in the classroom, and nutrition and agriculture education. Of course, none of this work would have been possible in Southampton without a robust collaboration between myself and a mutually influential wellness champion and CHISC community coordinator, Kara Montesano. Kara, take it away.
Thanks, Patty. It has been a true accomplishment to see how all these essential community partners came together to make such a large impact in their community.
One of my proudest moments over the past 5 years was having our mayor, Mike Spann, agree to recognize retail establishments for implementing changes. So we worked with the mayor and his staff and establishes the Healthy Retail Establishment Hall of Fame.
All of these CHISC successes couldn't have been accomplished without strong partnerships and local champions. Here's what CHISC-funded organizations have to say about their partners and champions.
Our greatest strength and the greatest and our proudest moment is that we've created amazing partnerships within the community that work to help and teach kids about a healthy lifestyle, how to exercise, how to eat, how to grow their own food from the tower garden.
We are proud of the positive and productive partnerships we've established with several community subcontractors. Take pride in the work we have been able to achieve with our subcontractors. For example, translating the deliverables of CHISC, establishing progress monitoring to capture their work in alignment with Catalyst, and most importantly, accomplishing the CHISC work in the MCDs of Buffalo and Elmira.
We have more and more champions taking on leadership roles from the school and the community who will continue to sustain many of these physical activity and nutrition initiatives.
We see some of our school members that we work with as champions, but I think they also see us as champions because we are leaders to them. We come in and we're allies. We help them not only develop a vision, but help them implement and further their vision for wellness within their school and community.
The work that we have been able to do is incredibly impactful on the health and well-being of all of the community members in the communities that we've been fortunate enough to work. The collaborative partnerships that we have been able to form will continue for years. And I'm truly blessed to have had the opportunity to love a job this much, and also to have built lasting friendships in all of these different communities.
So I just wanted to say thank you for letting me be a part of CHISC these 5 years. I have loved every minute of it. I made some wonderful lifelong friends with staff, with our community partners.
From all of us at OPCE, we want to thank you for your dedication and hard work over the last 5 years. Congratulations on all of your accomplishments.